Hello students, my name is Hemant Singh and I'll be taking your online chemistry classes. For I have already begun with the first chapter, that is some basic concepts of chemistry. In that I have already taught many things regarding mole concept. Okay, so many things regarding mole concept, like how to find number of moles and all. And now I have already started with stoichiometry coefficient and all. And based on that, the important thing, that is combustion reactions, we will discuss today. But before that, I would like to inquire and wish for your safe and healthy life in your back at home. Okay, so now we have to resume all our classes, all our work slowly, and we have to adapt ourselves in this life standard and whatever the situation nature has put before us. So we have to adapt according to this and we keep focus on our careers and our work and whatever is our primary function. For example, if you are a student, your primary work is just to studies, no matter it is winter or summer. Even if it's extreme summer, you have to study. Even if it's extreme winter, you have to study, like whatever a doctor does, regardless of the weather, or any person or any labor or any person, their work is not affected by the effect of weather or effect of any illness or anything. So we have to resume our studies. So that's why we are now coming on these many platforms, like online classes have been introduced for teaching. So let's begin with combustion reactions, which is based on stoichiometric reactions of the topic mole concept. Okay, so see, we have combustion reactions means which burn, and burning always occurs in presence of oxygen only. Burning always occurs in presence of oxygen. So we have two types of combustion reaction. First is complete combustion and second is incomplete combustion. So if we have complete combustion, let's see one example. Suppose we have carbon. So with reaction with oxygen, it will give you CO2. But when it will give you CO2, and one reaction we have of carbon with oxygen, we get only CO, that is carbon monoxide and carbon dioxide. Now what is the difference in between both the cases, and when we will get carbon monoxide and when we will get carbon dioxide? So we will get carbon dioxide when oxygen is present in excess of quantity, and if we have a limited supply of oxygen, we can only manage to get carbon monoxide. Okay, now for example, suppose in open air, open environment, we are burning any carbon piece, whether it is from in form of rubber or whether it is form of a tire or any plastic, anything, glucose, sugar, anything, wood, anything you are burning, you are burning carbon in presence of oxygen. And in air, oxygen is an unlimited supply. There is no restriction for oxygen supply in an open environment. So obviously it will give you carbon dioxide. But if we are doing combustion in a closed vessel in which there is a limited supply of oxygen, so we will in that case carbon can only manage to get converted in case of carbon monoxide only. So this is the difference between complete combustion and incomplete combustion. Whereas if we take water molecule or hydrogen, so hydrogen, combustion of hydrogen will give you water, whether it is in case of oxygen in excess or in case of oxygen in a limited supply. So you will get water vapor because there is no other option for hydrogen to combine with oxygen. But in case of carbon, oxygen has two cases where it can combine, either in form of a dioxide or in form of a monoxide. But here only monoxide can be attached to hydrogen. This is based on a different concept, size ratio. Okay, so stability, so all that. So we'll not get into that. As we'll progress further in chemistry topic, you will get to understand why it is stable, why monoxide of hydrogen is monoxide of oxygen is stable with two hydrogens, and whereas dioxide is also stable and somewhat stability, not that stable, but somewhat monoxide of carbon is also stable with carbon. Okay, so this is combustion reactions. Now next we'll see how to balance a combustion reaction. So this we need to have understand, as there are so many unlimited, vast, infinite number of carbon products in our environment. We are using everywhere we have carbon surrounded, wood, plastics, everywhere we have plastics or wood, anything related, plastic, anything you imagine, food particles, sugar, everything involves sugar and glucose in one or another form, everything is carbon around us. So we need to know what will be the combustion reaction, and as we cannot mug up so many infinite number of forms of carbon and their combustion, so we need to have some general formula or general point of view about the products of combustion of hydrocarbons. Okay, so first let us write a combustion reaction. So first we are considering, suppose we have a hydrocarbon which contains X atoms of carbon and Y atoms of hydrogen. Combustion means reaction with oxygen, because in absence of oxygen, combustion can never take place. You cannot ignite a fire in a vacuum or in absence of oxygen. You must have studied that candle experiment. Candle in an open environment will continue to burn, but as soon as you cover it with a glass, so it will continue to burn only after for a limited period of time, or we can say until the quantity of all of the oxygen inside the glass is utilized or burned. So only till that time candle will be ignited, after that it will extinguish. Okay, so understand. So any hydrocarbon which contains X atoms of carbon and Y atoms of hydrogen, on combustion, any hydrocarbon on combustion will give you CO2 as product along with waters only. Always any hydrocarbon on combustion will give you CO2 and H2O. Now how to balance this? So first step is to write our combustion reaction. I'll take one real life example also. Suppose we are considering combustion of glucose, which is most common and present in every other form of food product. So it is also a hydrocarbon and it will give you CO2 and H2O. See, first step is to balance number of carbon atoms. First step obviously is to write a combustion reaction. Second step is how to balance in balancing. First step is to find balance number of carbon atoms. So to balance number of carbon atoms, we have X carbon here on left hand side. So we'll write simply X. Here we have 6 carbons, so we'll write 6. Okay, so carbon is balanced on both sides of the reaction. Next step is to balance number of hydrogen atoms on both sides. So for balancing number of hydrogen atoms, we need, see here we have Y hydrogen on left hand side, where we have 2Y. Okay, we can say we already double amount is present. So what we'll do, we divide it by, suppose I'll give you a real life example also. If we have Y hydrogen and here we are already having 2, so what we'll do, we'll multiply it by half. See, so then only Y and Y we'll get. So here we already have Y hydrogen atoms, so what we'll do, we'll multiply it by Y by 2. Okay, now last step. In this case also, we have 12 hydrogen atoms. So what we'll do, we'll multiply by, for obtaining 12, we'll get 6. Multiply it by, 6. Okay, that is 12 by 2. We have 12 here and we need to get 12. But we already are having 2, so what we'll do, we'll multiply it by 12 by 2. Now get it? So we get 12 and 12. Okay, so we'll divide it by 2. Okay, we have 12 here already, so what we'll do, we'll 12 by 2, so we'll get 6 into, already we have 2, so we'll multiply. 12 by 2 will get 6. I hope I can make it understand to you in this way. So last step is to balance, and oxygen is balanced at last. So see, let's see how many oxygen we are having. We are having here 2x plus y by 2. 2x plus y by 2. And here already we are having 2. So what we'll do, we'll multiply this 2x plus y by 2. Let's do in rough first. 2x plus y by 2, we'd multiply with, already we are having 2, so multiply it by 1 by 2. So let's introduce this 1 by 2 inside the bracket, so we'll get 2x by 2, x plus, and this will become y by 4. So what we are getting, x plus y by 4. So here oxygen will be x plus y by 4 times. and this will apply in next equation also. So in next equation C, oxygen, let's calculate oxygen. Oxygen is 6 to the 12 plus 6, that is 18. 18 oxygen atoms. So here, how to make 18? So what we'll do, 2 already we are having, so 9. Or whatever we are getting here, we will multiply it with 1/2. So 1/2 is 9. So in this way, we can balance any combustion reaction of any hydrocarbon. And we need not to mug up the chemical reactions. Now till 9-10th, whatever way you have studied, you have written 5 times everything, 5 times homework was given to you 5 times, or simply mugging up the guides and all, or the teachers are making it. But in 11-12th science, if you want to qualify for JEE, if you want to become a doctor or an engineer, no bookish language will make you a doctor or engineer. Okay, you have to devise a way to generalize the things and remember them in your head. Okay, not every operation you will be taught if you are studying in a medical college, not every operation will come to you when you will become a doctor as the way it had been taught in the medical colleges or as you have studied in the books. There will be some different cases. You have to improvise, you have to innovate some other way based on your studies, based on the concepts you have built, or based on the understanding you have developed. So that will make you a better person in your career, and that will only make you advance and career. Okay, so this is how to balance our general combustion reaction. I hope it is clear. So as per stoichiometry, first we have to do, let's see some more examples. We'll see some more examples of this, but I hope it is clear. General molecular formula for balancing of combustion reaction, as well we have taken one example of glucose. Let's take some more examples. Let's start with the simplest hydrocarbon present. Simplest hydrocarbon is CH4 plus oxygen will give you CO2 plus H2O. Okay, CH4 plus oxygen will give you CO2 plus H2O. Next is, which comprises of two carbon atoms, that is C2H4 plus oxygen gives you CO2 plus H2O. Next is C3H8 plus O2 gives you, obviously it will give you, everything will give you CO2 and H2O. C4H10 plus oxygen, CO2 plus H2O. And one more is C6H6 plus oxygen gives you CO2 plus H2O. So you have to balance all these just to practice your concepts, whatever we have seen in general formula, and whether it applies to this or not. Okay, let me do it one for you, the simplest one or the hardest one, you may advise me. So first I'll take the simplest one. Simplest one is methane. For methane, first step is to write combustion reaction, it is already written. Now balance number of carbon atoms, so 1 and 1, both sides have 1 carbon atoms. Hydrogen, we have 4 hydrogen here, 2 hydrogen here, so we'll make it 2 times and it will become 4 hydrogen atoms on right hand side as well. Now number of oxygen atoms, 2 and 2 into 1, that is total 4 oxygen atoms on right hand side, so on left hand also we'll make it 2 times. Then next one also I hope you can do. Let me try this with butane. This is known as butane. Bute means 4 carbon. This is propane. Prop means 3 carbon, and this is 4 carbon. Then ethane. Eth means 2 carbon, and methane. Meth means 1 carbon. Okay, so this is the thing. Now C2H4, so C4H10, I'm doing this first. C4H10, 4 carbon, 4, let's make it 4. 10 hydrogen, we have 2, let's make it 10. And now last is oxygen balance, 4 2s are 8, and 5, 13. 13/2, because we have 13 on left hand side, here already we have 2, so what to do, we'll do 13/2. okay, then only we'll get 13, so 13 by 2. We can simply write 13 by 2 or 6.5, anything you like. I hope you get this. Next, C3H8, let's try C3H8. So C3H8, 3 carbon and 3 carbon. So let's balance the carbon first. For 8 hydrogen and, let's make it 8 also here, right hand side. Oxygen, 3 to the 6 and 4, 10. Here we have 2, so 10. And here we already have 2. How to make it 10? We'll just multiply 10 by 2. Huh? 6 and 4, so we'll get 10. So what we have done, 10 by 2 is 5. We'll add 5, so it is balanced. Next you can do, this is benzene, C6H6, I hope everybody can do. So let me try this also, benzene. See, 6 carbon and 6 carbon. So balanced. Here we have 6 carbons and 2 hydrogen, 3. Then oxygen, 6 to the 12 and 3, 15. So here it will come 15 by 2. Simple. This is very simple for you now, I hope. So I hope I have made it very clear. And we'll just implement these concepts, balancing of combustion reaction, these concepts in the questions that we are going to discuss further here. Okay, let's look at the questions now. After learning the concept of balancing of any hydrocarbon reaction, any form of hydrocarbon and combustion of it, after we are thorough with the concept of balancing of that reaction, let's see how we will use those methods or those concepts of balancing a hydrocarbon reaction in any stoichiometric question which contains combustion reactions. Okay, so see what is given for the following combustion reaction at STP. First, we have to first given following combustion reactions. Which combustion reactions? First is 48 gram of CH4. We have first is 48 gram of CH4. Combustion of 48 gram of CH4. 2.8 kg of C2H4. 10 liters of C3H8. And 3 into 10 is to power 24 molecules of C3H4. For each of the 4 given combustion reactions, we have to find mass and volume of oxygen required for each of them combustions, and also we have to find what will be the mass and volume of CO2 required, but CO2 is not required, rather CO2 is produced. So we'll write that, find mass and volume of CO2 produced. Okay. So let's start with, I'll do 2 cases with you, I'll discuss 2 cases with you. Rest of the 2 cases you can try it for yourself. Okay, the first one is 48 gram of CH4. So first step is what? First step is to write balance chemical combustion reaction for combustion of hydrocarbon. So first we'll write combustion of CH4 plus O2 gives you CO2 plus H2O. Okay, so this is your balanced combustion reaction. Let's write a little bit up also. CH4 plus O2 gives you CO2, obviously CO2 and H2. Okay, obviously CO2 and H2. Now see, balancing. Carbon is 1 on both the sides of the reaction. Then comes the turn of hydrogen. Hydrogen is 4. Here it is 2, so we'll make it 4. And oxygen, now let's count oxygen, 2 into 1, 2 plus 2, 4, here it is 2, so we'll make it 4 on left hand side also. Now the reaction is completely balanced. Now we'll write, according to stoichiometry, see what is here, according to stoichiometry, that 1 mole of CH4 reacts with 2 mole of oxygen gives us 1 mole of CO2 and along with 2 moles of H2O. According to stoichiometry, it means this. Okay? That 1 mole of CH4 reacts with 2 moles of oxygen to give us 1 mole of CO2 and 2 mole of H2O. So this is important. In first case, we are only concerned with how many CH4 and how many oxygen. Now see, according to stoichiometry we have written, now we should also see according to the quantities given in the question. According to quantity given in question. Now see, in stoichiometry, in first lecture of stoichiometry, I have already told you whatever is the given quantity, whatever in whatever format it is, will the quantity is given, in whatever parameter the quantity is given, we have to convert that in terms of mole for solving for stoichiometry. So we have to convert that in terms of moles. Okay, so here it is, 48 gram of CH4 is given. So we'll convert, take 48 gram, that is weight given, and divided by molecular weight, divided by molecular weight will give us number of moles. Okay, we are thorough with this. So here 16, okay, 16, 3 moles of CH4. According to given question, we have 3 moles of CH4. Now see, 1 mole of CH4 gives or requires 2 mole of oxygen. So likewise, 3 moles of CH4 will require, 1 mole requires 2 moles, so 3 mole will require 6 moles of oxygen. 6 moles of oxygen are required. So we have found the quantity moles of oxygen required. Moles of oxygen required. Now we have to tell what is the mole, this requirement of moles, that is 6 moles. What is the mass of 6 mole and volume of 6 mole? So we'll convert 6 moles of oxygen into mass. 6 moles of oxygen in mass. 1 mole of oxygen weighs, 1 mole of oxygen means whatever will 1 mole of oxygen will weigh, that will be equal to its molecular weight. Molecular weight of oxygen is 32 grams. So 1 mole of oxygen weighs 32 grams. So 6 mole will weigh 6 into 32 grams. And 1 mole of any gas, 1 mole of any gas occupies volume 22.4 liters. So 6 mole of oxygen will occupy 6 into 22.4 liters. So 6 into 32 grams, we'll get 6 2s are 12, 6 3s are 18 and 1, 19. 192 grams of oxygen for complete combustion of 48 grams of CH4. And in terms of volume, we will be having 6 4s are 24. Point we'll put 6 2s are 12, then 14. 6 to the 12 and 134.4 liters in terms of volume. 6 moles of oxygen in terms of mass will be 192 grams, and in terms of volume it will be 134.4 liters. So I hope we got first part of our question asked. I hope it is clear till now. Next, we'll find mass and volume of CO2 produced. Now see, mass and volume of CO2 produced will be, mass and volume of CO2 produced, see. Now we are concerned with how much mass and volume of CO2 will be produced. So we'll again see, according to stoichiometry, or we can write down, see, as per stoichiometry, one mole of CH4 produces, 1 mole of CH4 produces 1 mole of CO2. 1 mole of CO2. So similarly, or therefore, as per stoichiometry, therefore 48 grams CH4, that is 3 mole CH4, will give us 3 mole of CO2. Okay? So it will give us 3 mole of CO2. Now this 3 mole of CO2, what is the mass of and volume of this 3 mole of CO2? See, mass and volume of this 3 mole of CO2. So mass, 1 mole CO2 weighs 44 grams. 1 mole CO2 weighs beta 44 grams. So 3 mole will weigh 3 into 44 grams. Similarly, 1 mole of any gas weighs 22.4 liters. So 1 mole of any gas, CO2, H2O, NO2, any gas, 1 mole is 22.4 liters. So similarly, 1 mole of CO2 will be 3 into 22.4 liters. Okay, just multiply it and write the answers yourself. Everybody try it. So I am also doing it. So 3 into 44, 4 3 is 12,
132 grams in terms of mass, and so 67.2 liters in terms of volume. Okay, so I hope this is the clear concept. Whatever is the given quantity, first we have to convert that in terms of moles, and then whatever is asked, first we have to write according to the stoichiometry, and then according to the quantity given in the question, convert it to moles, and then we'll see in similar ratio of stoichiometry. So in this way, we are going to solve these questions related to these. Okay, one more question, fourth one also I'll discuss. You just have to convert each and everything in terms of moles. I'm telling you again how, if weight is given, the number of moles is weight given upon molecular weight. In kgs also, it is weight only, the formula applied will be same. Just you have to convert kg into grams, because molecular weight will always be in grams. It cannot be represented in kgs. No molecule will weigh in kgs until unless it is a polymer. Then volume. So how to convert volume into number of moles? We have already discussed in detail in so many lectures. Volume given upon 22.4 liters. And for this, we are going to discuss and solve also using same similar concepts. Okay. So just note it down, each and everybody. And then try the remaining second and third part yourself, and fourth one we are gonna discuss just now. So see, one more part I will be trying, that is the fourth part. So the equation for fourth part is that we have C3H4 plus oxygen will give you CO2 plus H2O. Okay, so balanced with three, we have three carbon on left hand side, so we'll make this say three. Then hydrogen we have four here on left hand side, and right hand side we have only two, so we'll multiply it by two. And oxygen, see 3 to the 6 and 2 8, so oxygen will be 4. Okay, so we have equal number of atoms on both sides of the reaction. Now according to stoichiometry, first let's see according to stoichiometry. So according to stoichiometry, one mole of C3H4 reacts with 4 mole of oxygen to give us 3 mole of CO2 and 2 mole of H2O. Now see, according to quantity given in the question, Now in question we have been provided with number of molecules. Number of molecules we denoted by N. So how we'll find number of moles? So find number of moles in this case, N is equal to N by NA. As we have already discussed in so many lectures about this, so many numericals we have done on this topic. So N is small n, number of moles is equal to N upon NA. So that is 3.011 into 10 raised to power 24 molecules divided by Avogadro number of molecules, that is 6.022 into 10 raised to power 24. Okay. So let's calculate this. This comes out to be 1 by 2 and 10 raised to power, it's 23, sorry. So 23, and we are left with 1 by 2 into 10, that comes out to be 5 mole of C3H4 are given in the question. So we have been provided with 5 mole of C3H4. Now since 1 mole of C3H4 requires 4 mole of oxygen, 1 mole of C3H4 requires 4 mole of oxygen, likewise 5 mole of C3H4 will require 4 into 5, that is 20 moles of oxygen. 20 moles of oxygen will be required for combustion of 5 mole of C3H4. Okay. Similarly, this is the first part. Now 20 moles of oxygen, what will be the mass of 20 moles of oxygen? So see, mass of 20 mole of oxygen, 1 mole of oxygen weighs 32 grams. Similarly, 20 moles will weigh 32 into 20. You can multiply this, and 1 mole of oxygen weighs 22.4 liters. So volume will be 20 into 22.4 liters. Okay, similarly as we have done in the first case.
Now let's come to how much, what will be the mass and volume of CO2 produced. So since we can write down as we have written previously, as per stoichiometry, 1 mole of C3H4 yields, produces 3 mole of CO2. Likewise, as per the given quantity of question, which in terms of moles is 5 moles, likewise 5 moles of C3H4 will give you 5 threes are 15, right? So 15 moles of CO2 okay, so 15 moles of CO2. So what will be the mass and volume of 15 moles of CO2? So mass, 1 mole of CO2 will be 15 into 44 grams, and volume will be, 1 mole of CO2 is 22.4 liters, so 15 into 22.4 liters. Okay, so what will be the product? That will be your answer. I hope now you get it and you can easily do rest of the two cases. In this case we have 2.8 kg, so kg needs to be converted into grams and divided by molecular weight of C2H4, and in 10 liters of C3H8 we have volume given divided by 22.4 liters. So I hope today's topic on based on stoichiometric reactions of combustion reaction and numericals related to it are clear, and you can solve it easily for on further practice from your sheet or reference books or textbooks. Okay, so we'll meet in next lecture. Till then, thank you and have a safe day.